時間が5分。
一時期や、おい。
寝ろとか。
Issues around immigration and citizenship are as poignant now as they've ever been, and the history of America is a history of migration. This is footage of a protest at Grand Army Plaza taken from the summer of 2021, right outside of Brooklyn Public Library's Central Branch.
Within recent memory, this site and our library have often been an inviting space for community to gather, to protest, and to question the status quo.
Hi, my name is Haleen.
Hi, my name is Ajwa.
And we are librarians with the Brooklyn Public Library.
We are part of BPL's Alternative Classification Committee, where our goals are to identify and provide recommendations for updates to the library's cataloging and classification terminology, and also to develop community education and engagement in order to learn from our patrons about harmful language used in our catalog and classification systems.
Over the last year, the committee has held panels with authors, scholars, publishers, library staff, and patrons, and also held screenings of the documentary Change the Subject, which follows a group of Dartmouth students on a quest against the Library of Congress's use of subject headings as a form of categorization.
Here, we've had our own quest of sorts to document the community and the relationship to language within our institution's library catalog. Visiting with various groups throughout Brooklyn, we've primarily gathered their thoughts, perceptions, and feelings regarding the term, quote, illegal alien.
For this video, we not only imagine what the patron experience might be like while seeing such outdated terms in our catalog, we ask the public directly.
When I was little, my mom, my family, and I, we lived in a predominantly white area, and I would hear the term illegal alien amongst other not so nice words used towards to describe my mom, even though she's a legal citizen.
We are going to explore how the usage of outdated language affects not only the people who the term is being used for, but also how it reinforces negative perceptions of immigrant communities in our society through media, news, publishing, and politics.
Imagine you are a student researching America's immigration history. How do you even begin your search?
Let's start here. What exactly is a subject heading anyway?
The Brooklyn Public Library, like most libraries in the United States, has taken cataloging language cues from the Library of Congress, but it has now made a major exception with the term illegal alien. That subject heading is being replaced with new headings such as undocumented and non-citizen.
And in our interviews, the public had amazing and sometimes conflicting ideas about new words to use in their place.
I think that term needs to go. Undocumented, you know, they have the people are saying that now. I think that it's definitely better than illegal. But it's not forward-looking.
Right.
You know, like, I don't know.
Still, there's something.
There's something, like, you don't have something. You're not part of this culture. You're not part of this group. It could be, I don't know, I think maybe something like, I don't know, future Americans, striving Americans, something like that. You know, people trying to become citizens or...
So we should really lighten up on the term illegal alien and lighten up on the word alien to foreigners. I think it's time now we find a better word to describe these people, or describe us, as you could hear, and I do have an accent. And, you know, I think they should lighten it up and find a much better term instead of just calling us aliens. We are not aliens. If I get a cut on my skin, this alien blood will be red, it wouldn't be green. So let's deconnotize that and find a much more suitable word.
In the summer of 2020, the Brooklyn Public Library officially masked the subject heading illegal alien within our local catalog, which means that the term illegal alien will no longer be visible as a subject heading. Though we cannot change the Library of Congress's terminology, the Brooklyn Public Library, along with the New York Public Library, have replaced the Library of Congress terms within our own local authority records. On a monthly basis, our vendor checks for any new records cataloged with the term illegal immigration and or related terms, and converts it to the local preferred term undocumented immigration and related terms. The New York Public Library checks for this daily, while the Brooklyn Public Library catalog will mask the term or terms if we find them in between the monthly vendor updates.
I mean, I've never been called that personally. Both my parents are immigrants from Nigeria. They've never been called that personally either. When you say it, it kind of gives me negative feelings. I mean, just the word alien by itself is kind of like, you know, isn't something that's like a term of endearment necessarily. So, yeah, I mean, I think we could probably use a different word around that to describe people from different places, you know what I mean?
Well, I just think that the term illegal alien is like something that makes me kind of uncomfortable in a way. Just because they come from a different country, they shouldn't be seen as aliens. They're human beings just like us. I'm just like happy that now it's like being recognized more. That's a term, like a derogatory term in a way, and it shouldn't be used anymore.
Word. I don't like when people call you illegal alien. It's not good. It hurts. I've been there and I know what I say back. Especially when they call me too a foreigner. I know I'm in a foreign country. I'm not illegal. I have my citizenship. I have everything. And that's it.
The word illegal is a bad, it's a trigger for me. Illegal, yeah. That's a word that should not be used. That's a criminal word. That we're not criminals.
I don't think it's right.
We're not criminals.
I think everybody should just be treated equally. Let everybody just rock the way they want to rock and just be happy.
And those that come from far, that are allowed into this country, I'm sorry, sometimes work harder than the ones that legally
that
have
live,
the right
that
to
live
be
here.
And don't have papers. Work for $0 and work harder.
And work harder and they bust their
it.
Butt. Do you
yes.
know what I'm saying? Like.
I
think everyone should be treated fairly. People come over
they
here because they want a better place for their children. Mm-hmm. Not to be haciendo bandida, I had doing crazy stuff. Like, I came here, a yellow brick road, let's go follow and see where it takes us.
Okay. That's what it's supposed to be, right? The United States. Freedom of everything.
Freedom of speech.
In March of 2016, the Library of Congress announced their plan to change the subject headings containing illegal aliens with two new headings. Non-citizens and unauthorized immigration. Republican lawmakers made several attempts to prevent the Library of Congress from making revisions to subject headings containing illegal alien. The proceeding went on to state that because the term illegal alien is used in Title 8 of the U.S. Code, it should remain as the preferred term.
But, as of November of 2021, the Library of Congress has altered their bibliographic records subject heading term from illegal alien to illegal immigrant, in effect, removing the word alien.
For many, this alteration misses the point of the original Change the Subject and Drop the I campaigns, that a person's humanity and citizenship shouldn't be tied to criminality. That people themselves cannot inherently be illegal or legal. The term alien might otherize a person, but the term illegal stigmatizes them too.
Public libraries across the country, such as Brooklyn Public Library, are taking it upon themselves to counter the effects of terminology within their catalogs for this very reason, in order that collections are reflective of the pride taken in being welcoming to everyone.
And when we work with and within various immigrant communities that use our services and seek feedback on how those services affect them, we demonstrate a willingness to create, maintain, and nourish a welcoming environment.
So when you say the words illegal alien, right, I just cringe. Like, it just feels really harsh and inhuman to me. So I support your efforts to change that language wherever possible.
I think
think it's a wonderful thing that term is something that will be outdated, no longer used. Any terminology that offends people, I think it's really important that it stops being used and that we introduce new vocabulary into our language and new terminology, because offending anybody is the very last thing anybody should ever want to do. So I think it's a wonderful thing that the library is taking steps to get rid of that. So thank you.